Hey guys, hope you're having a great day as well as a great life.
Dude, voting day. My favorite voting day of the week.
The day where you guys get to let your voices be heard and choose bangers that will get thrown in the rotation.
Facts. This one was, I think, the closest one we've ever had.
Closest poll we ever had. There was like one at like 29%, one at 31%, one at 34%. And actually, the time of the season by the Zombies was winning for a couple hours. Mm-hmm. And Black Betty caught up. And I think this comment I want you to read out real quick summarizes why it probably won.
Okay, so this is from Jason Remy. And he basically goes like all four are fantastic, like he says like why each one is good. He's like, oh, Jeff Buckley might be is like the best singer ever and like had a super tragic backstory, but then he says, but I had to go with Ram Jam, Black Betty. It's the bangeriest banger to ever bang. It slaps so hard it'll make you wish you had a safe word. It has got to win his poll, but I would not feel bad if any of them win, but it should be Black Betty.
I think that's the most fair one of the most fair comments I've ever seen, and just like that's a great comment.
Yeah, just so we wanted to shout it out, because like all right.
Crazy stuff. Definitely subscribe and make sure you can vote in those polls and comment on the polls and let us know what your thoughts are, what other options should be. With that, if you're here on the live premiere, thanks for being here.
Yeah, we're going to be down there in the comments with you if you got there right when the video dropped or a little bit before.
Absolutely. But yeah, super excited to check out Ram Jam, Black Betty. Let's go ahead and do it, man.
See ya. Ooh, okay.
Okay. It's a whiskey song.
That song is phenomenal.
That kick drum, dude.
That bass, dude. I'm gonna spill my whiskey, dude. Oh my God. my goodness.
All right, first thing, man, when the vocals came in, immediately recognizable.
Yes, I definitely heard the Bambalam part.
Yep, like just like when the vocals started, I was like, oh my god, I've heard this as like a young child, yeah, and a couple key various points in my life. Never recall hearing the whole song like at all. At least this cut where it had like the drum stuff and all this, dude, crazy.
Dude, it's crazy that you can say Bam-a-lam 800 times and make such a hard. For one, he was so right. This was definitely the biggest banger I think we've had on the channel.
There was a point where I was like, honestly, if I had a safe word right now, I might use it.
Yeah.
There was a couple, like, especially like, when
orange
we have,
slice,
like,
orange slice.
It's like, oh my goodness, dude. Oh. And like, so while the guitar solo is like a wailing in all the right ways, emphasizing all the right notes and phrases. So that's happening over here, right? And then the bass player underneath him, bro,
was so good.
Like doing like, he's the bassist that you want if you're a guitarist to tie you and the drummer together. He's the guy you want.
Dude, he's such a good bassist that if you didn't have a guitarist, you could make do.
Yeah, it's just that bass guy was going nuts. I don't know how his hands were doing all that, dude.
That was definitely like you go into like a Chipotle and getting extra guac and then accidentally not charging you for it.
That's one of the situations for sure.
Dude, there was so much amazing stuff that happened in this song. Like, I almost don't know what to, like, it literally felt like they were like, all right, what are the coolest things of rock and roll? Let's have all of them and just throw them in until we can't throw any more in. Like, let's fill the pot with everything we can.
And then at the same time, it still doesn't feel crowded.
No.
It literally feels like you have just enough room to breathe to where it's like, if you had a safe word, you might use it, but maybe you wouldn't.
You're like,
maybe
you're I think still I can make this.
I can make it through. Yeah. Like, it's like, oh my goodness. It's just,
Mama didn't raise no bitch.
Yeah, exactly. This song feels timeless to me.
Yeah.
It feels like if I played this for my kid, he better be bobbing his freaking head.
Or he's grounded.
Yeah, it's just one of those songs you can't deny. It's like
fun.
Influence, and it's fun. It's like, jeez, dude. Goodness, I just gracious. I don't know like what else you can say about the song to give it the praise that it deserves. It's just, it's a great song.
The only negative I had is I felt like some of the transitions were a little harsh.
That's fair in terms of like the timing and stuff like that. Like,
and
the,
so
the
it
rhythm
makes me
changes.
Wonder if they could do it live. I know we asked that a lot of like really really good songs. We're like, well, I wonder if they could do it live. Yeah. But this one I worry a little bit because it's such a weird feeling time. Like,
yeah, if you're playing with that fast and that intensity, it's like, can you make those weird time changes like very quickly?
Make them feel natural because they don't feel super natural in the song. And it's fine though.
The changes, the time changes, at least on the first like listen all the way through, the time changes, I forgot about that, were not, I would say they were not digestible. Like,
yes.
In like a way to where it's like you had to go, oh, like it grabs your attention. Whereas usually like you don't want it to grab your attention in that way where it's like a readjusting way where, oh, I have to now like readjust to this rhythm rather than some kind of like gateway. But either way, if that's the only thing, it's like, damn, dude, great song.
Yeah, I thought that was impeccable. Thought it was impeccable.
I think even with that, I don't see why I would give it any less than S for me.
I think I could
see myself and you or anybody argue the A+, but I feel like I'm just not going to do that.
Also, we're not going to get into the lyrics.
we still can, but without the lyrics, S.
You're gonna need to give me a minute, dude. Because I feel like, oh, from Alabama, bro. All right, yeah, S. I give it an S.
We don't need to read the lyrics. We know it's an S. We know it's a banger. We know it's all these things. It's like
somebody's like, oh, but it actually had this really, really deep meaning.
It's like, we know what the meaning
was.
They
definitely just drank 18 Bud Lights and we're like, bam, lam.
You know, absolutely.
They're like, we don't got words to this song yet. You gonna put it out? Nah, it's fine. We'll just record it.
This is just one of those songs, one of these like videos where it's like energy is really high. It just feels like it's fun.
Yeah.
Very, very much fun. Yeah. It's like, this is like, you have like, we have a recording session, like we have a song like this, a video like this. It's like, oh, I'm driving home very much happier than when I showed up to record.
Facts.
And that's just like how it kind of like, videos like this, songs like this is what gives me that kind of feeling.
Yeah. Oh man. That being said, thank you guys for watching it with us.
All
for
that
showing
shit.
It to us. Go vote in that poll because we would not hear the song if you hadn't voted in the polls. It was really close. Very, very close tie on that one. So make your voice heard.
Yep.
Make sure we only get the bangeriest of bangers.
Absolutely.
That being said,
we'll see you guys next week. I think that's solid stuff, dude.